All right. So hopefully you guys can hear me okay. I'm trying to set it to where I don't sound so muffled. Bienvenidos todos. Shane Bowles already left a message in the chat. The Guardians of the Galaxy scooter sounds dope. So what's up, everybody? Here we have the canvas, and I think we'll just get into it today. I mean, there's no reason to say much. I have a baby Groot, right? We set up a baby Groot, and we have him hitting the switch here, the wrong switch, or the wrong button, you know? So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do this KO style. What's up? How's it going? I feel like I'm extra loud. There you go, let me turn that down. Cool. Alright, cool. Monique Higgins, how's it going? So I'm just going to start off by doing the background first before anything. And so I'm going to load up some blue. I'm going to start off with the Caribbean blue. And then we'll add a little darker tone to it. Turn down the pressure a little bit here. Oh, that's too low. There we go. Throw some reducer in here. Con que pintura trabajas? Oh my gosh, man. Here, actually, that's a good reminder that I should probably have it up here. Can you see it there? There, you can see it. Createx. I'm gonna need black. I'm gonna need white too. I'm gonna need brown. Let's see here. We need some sand. Uso la pintura Createx. Oh jeez. Was this Caribbean blue? And then I'm gonna throw in some turquoise. Is this open? Yeah, it's open. Turquoise. Sounds about right. And then maybe some deep blue. Cool. Oh, and then we need a green. Do I have a bright green? Fluorescent green. With forest green. Oh my god, look at all these colors here. Oh, we're gonna go through some colors today, boy. Can you see what paint I use? Si se puede ver que pintura eso? Eric Todd, what's up? Chris, how's it going? Alright. I think I have it all ready now. So I'm gonna throw some reducer in here. And then I'm gonna throw in some of this Caribbean blue. Shake it up. Big Gordo, what's up? Why? All right, cool. So, how's everybody doing today? Hope everybody's doing good. All okay. So here we go. Get this all mixed up real good. You found the secret door for the videos? Nice. Okay, so Oh, I don't even have the reference up. Let me pull up the reference picture. Oh my gosh, how did I get this thing? Okay, go. Sorry, just trying to get the reference picture up so I can see. Just outside, huh? Cool. Yeah, the brat here just woke up, so probably go outside after this. Gustavo, saludos. Got all that in there. Gonna need some blue hues in here. Gracias, gordo. PSI right now is about at 20-25. So I'm just gonna take my Caribbean blue here and I'm gonna add a couple drops of this deep blue. Like literally 1-2 drops of deep blue. Not gonna add any more reducer. So we just wanted to shift that tone just a bit. Just a bit. What's up, Paul Tarchala? He got the fake skulls. I like the fake skulls too. They all right. They're all right. How's everybody doing today? Just we're gonna keep a pretty bright palette on here. I'm gonna try to at least, so I don't want to go too dark on anything. Doing good. Wife had to go into work today, so It's nice, and daughter just woke up. Up all kinds into the night, and I'm here painting, so I can't complain. All good. I hope you guys are doing good. How are you doing? How's everybody holding up, man? No, I didn't freehand it. We started with a sketch today. I already had it sketched out. Just save time. There's a lot going on with this character. I decided to actually like have it drawn out beforehand, so. got that in there. I'm just gonna, again, same mixture. I'm just gonna add one, two more drops. No, let's make it three. Three more drops. That's really gonna change it up a little bit. But it's still gonna have that brightness of the Caribbean blue in there. Mixing it up real good, you know. Whoa! And there goes the camera. Alright, cool. There you go. Oh shit, Eric Todd in the house. Ve mis reviews de los Master Airbrush si quieres mi opinión. Tengo videos. Look at that, this is looking real nice. Real nice. Your computer's mean a butt, huh? How does that work? Are you sure it's not the user error, man? Look at that, I got all that background blue. And I think I'm just gonna go in and just add one drop mind you, probably a big drop. One drop. That's all we need out of there. It's not loading? Ah. Okay, that's the computer's fault. Alright, so now this is gonna be really, really dark. It does that on the Mac? Oh man, that's rough. I don't even own a Mac, but aren't Macs supposed to be like more reliable or something? I don't know. I use PC for everything because I like to build my computers and stuff. What's up, Peter? The stream's not loading. I don't know. It's working for me. I don't know, man. You guys make me nervous. Since 09, yeah, that's an old iPad, bro. When it comes to iPad terms, they expect you to upgrade that shit every year. I hope it's working for everybody else, man, because it's working for me. I don't know. Nobody else is saying anything. I hope everybody else is working. So I'm over here knocking out this blue wood. Alright, James, cool. It's really delayed, but it's working. Good. Oh, jeez. Thank you. think that's it for the blue. Oh wait, no. We gotta darken up some of this right here. What up, Justice? How's it going? I honestly can't believe the Groot won. I thought you guys were gonna pick Spawn or Goku. You guys were talking about Goku yesterday. I was like, oh, that sounds cool. You guys actually made it happen. Cool, so I'm just gonna go ahead and set this one aside. What's up, Easy Airbrush? How's it going? Take reducer again. We're gonna kind of work our way through the browns, starting with some sand. Alright, this time we're gonna mix up the base colors, so we're gonna throw in a good amount. Shake it up. Yeah, hanging in there, man. That's pretty much what we're all doing right now. Do you have a guess how long a painting like this can take when you get the idea? We'll know when I'm done. That's what I can say. I always say how long I've been streaming right before I stop streaming. If it's about yesterday's stream, it'd say about 2 hours. Yesterday, most of the streams recently have been about 2 hours. So. And it seems like it takes like a long time, but don't know. Just hanging out painting with you guys. And as long as the chat's busy and going, it seems like it goes pretty quick sometimes. What to tell payees when they call? What payees are you talking about? Because if you are basing your time off of my time, you are way off of time. That, or you are not going to deliver the same amount of detail. Or I don't know. Maybe you're another airbrusher just as good as me. You just don't airbrush YouTube like don't do YouTube videos. I don't know. But yeah. A lot of people ask how long for me. So that they have an idea, and it's just like, no, that's not the same for you. It's not the same. Don't know what a payee is, though. Payees. This canvas right here, I just primed it with white because it had another design on it, so I just went over it with white, brushed on some primer. Simple. You don't have to do anything special. If you want a supremely flat surface, you're just better off getting an illustration board and just not getting a canvas. But they are harder to work with, but so is the canvas when it's fully yesoed up. So. Pick your poison. A lot of guys try to get rid of that texture on the canvas. There's no point in getting rid of the texture. Yeah, there's no point in the canvas being smooth. You could try some illustration board, you'll be fine. Some gesso board works good. Thank you. The guy with the cash he be paying you. People that pay. That's what he was asking. Usually when people ask me how long it's gonna take, I usually just tell them as long as it takes. Because I don't know. It's hard to gauge. I could give them an estimate between 3 to 5 hours, you know. But once you commit to an actual number, then you're like tied up to that number. So you don't want to ever commit. When quoting a job or something. I always tell them, it's just going to take as long as it takes, man. Sometimes it's fast, sometimes it's slow. Depends. You can't really tell. Some jobs are obviously real easy, so you could just be like, yeah, this is going to take me, you know, a day, 2 hours, whatever. Knock it out, get out of there, you're good to go. Yo, what's up, Justice, with the $5? Nine times out of ten, you can't see it when I'm done, but it doesn't really bother me. I've yet to have somebody point it out. It used to bother me a lot. You know, I used to, like, try to hard to cover them or go back with white and stuff. And, yeah, but now I just really don't care. I think it bugs me more than it bugs anybody else. Most people don't even notice unless I point them out. Go like, oh yeah, that's, you know, the pencil line from my sketch. That they're like, oh wow, and then they get really close on it, you know, like they get their eyeballs right up on the painting. And they try to look for more, but at that point, you know, it's like you're just looking for flaws. Like they already like the painting. There's no point in trying to find flaws. So now I'm going to take this, same mixture, and again, Justice, what is that guy doing? He's dropping the mic. Oh, shit. So here I'm going to do 1, 2, 3 drops into the sand color, dark brown. Now I'm gonna go over the whole thing again. Done, son. I procrastinate if you don't give yourself a deadline. I don't ever procrastinate anything. Man, as soon as I get a job, I'm on that job. So the only thing that'll stop me is if I have to order supplies. Or, like, right now, my state's on lockdown. So, like, there's nothing I can do. Usually I get a job, though, I'm on it. And I don't start something else till I get that job out, especially like vehicles or motorcycles. It's usually one at a time, and they get done fast. I always have guys tell me, "Oh yeah, somebody told me, 3 months to get my stuff done," or, "He said he's backed up for this," and I'm, how do you do that? Like, man, I like painting, so if I was just that job every day, that's awesome. I'll just get a job done every day. Just reminds me and kind of makes me a little bit sad. My friend Cisco, that used to airbrush here in Denver, passed away not too long ago. And that just reminds me because he's kind of one of those procrastinator type of guys too. He's an older cat. We had our moments. But if you guys don't know, my first video on YouTube, my very, very, very first video on YouTube is actually a video that I wasn't even in, but it was shot in my apartment, and that's my friend Cisco. Was doing a how to airbrush lesson for beginners, and we decided to film it because at that time I had a little like Sony Handycam, so we were like, yeah, let's shoot it, we'll put it on YouTube. And yeah, we put it on YouTube, and to this day that video's still up. It's like Cisco Artistry or something like that. And he's wearing some shades. He's a funny guy. But yeah, he was kind of one of those guys who's just like procrastinating sometimes, man. Well, you guys can't even see what I'm doing. The glare is so bad. Oh, man. My bad. How come you guys don't see? How come you guys don't say anything, man? I'm just slowly building up all those little cracks and crevices. So they're just not just, you know, cracks. They're just like, there's little bends and twists and little shading and shadows are going in there. You feel like you procrastinate on stuff too? Get all that in there. Let's do a little bit of work down here. Too busy procrastinating and chatting. Shots fired, man. I think he was talking to you, dude. Just go ahead and throw a good squirt dark brown in there. So I would do it reversed if I was you. I would actually I would actually sketch it. He said pew pew. I would actually sketch it and then throw some white over it, because the white, it won't completely cover the pencil mark, but when you start painting over it, it'll make it easier to cover, and it won't, like, you won't be able to rub it, so it won't, like, you know, when you wipe with your hand, it won't rub away, you know, the pencil. So this guy said pew pew. Big Mike on the track. This beat sounds so dope. What's up, Valentin? What's up, hater? To mix paints in a cup, shake, backflush, mix with a paintbrush. I like to shake it. And then, you know, I'll spray through, make sure I get the color going through before I approach the canvas. But technically, all of those ways that you mentioned will work. The backflush is probably the least reliable one of all, because it might mix the paint, but you're also mixing in a bunch of air bubbles with it. So it's not a very reliable way of mixing and painting your cup. Shaking it, I guess you could argue too, but you're not throwing air directly into it. I would say do what you like, man. I used to mix it outside in a separate cup and then throw it in my airbrush when I liked the color. That's what I used to do. Then I realized that that just, A, takes too long, and B, it doesn't actually produce a better result when you're airbrushing. It's useful if you're doing something big, right, and you're going to need to mix up multiple cups. Yeah, mixing up a big, huge batch of, you know, a certain color saves you probably a lot of time. But it probably has nothing to do with how the end product will look. It's so easy to forget that it's just a little 8x10 canvas. And there's just so much, like, so yeah, he's just made out of wood. It sounds so easy. He's just kind of made out of wood. You know, all you gotta do is simulate the wood, you know? If it was just wood grain, I think it'd be easier than this. And one drop of black. That one killer drop, man, makes it dark. And then we can finally move on to some black and finish it up. Maybe some eye highlights, maybe. Maybe in the eyes. The fishing backwoods, fishing the backwoods, yo yo yo, how's it going? So here we go again. And now we have a really nice dark brown in there. Oh yeah, look at Justice. After seeing those in action, I think I did a pretty good job. You can tell what it is. Oh yeah, that reminds me. There's enough members now that I've unlocked more emojis. So probably after today's stream, I'm gonna get on there and make some more. So you guys have like, I think it's like two more. So there'll be like seven total emojis that you'll be able to use for members only. So it's gonna get more intense, boy. It's gonna be dope. You need vote on the next project. Yeah, dude, I leave those up. I put them up in the morning and I just like I go do my stuff and come back and I'm like, oh, that's what it is. And today the group won by like just barely a bit. It was actually like really close. And I checked it and I was like, oh, I don't know, man. Maybe I'll come back later. And then I came back and he was still winning. So I was like, all right, cool. I'll just the Groot it is. Need some juice?
No water.
Water?
But I have to go.
Okay, I'm gonna put it right here, okay? Good? You saw it last night. Oh, I haven't put up the one for tomorrow. I don't put up the one. So the one for tomorrow will be up like, in the morning. But I don't know if there's going to be a stream tomorrow because I have to prep more canvases. I have to find more canvases to paint, bro. They officially shut Hobby Lobby completely down. Like, somebody filed a complaint with the state after they caught some of the Hobby Lobbies in Springs open. So now all the Hobby Lobbies across the state are completely shut down. So I have no hopes there. I haven't gone back to Walmart. I'm kind of afraid to go to Walmart, to be honest with you. But that might be the only option, and hope they've restocked with anything other than 8x10s. I like 8x10s like this, don't get me wrong, but I like doing... Yeah, she goes back and forth between water and juice. So... And she's only allowed one cup of juice a day, but she usually has it like in the morning. It's her pick. And then throughout the day, we don't give her any more juice so that, you know, she could burn off the sugar. She's actually really smart, my guy. She's always been super perceptive since she was a baby, which is crazy. She used to just follow you in a room, and then, you know, you try to distract her to make her think that you left the room or something. She ain't falling for it, dude. She's just waiting for you to come back out of that room. And same thing now, like, she's just... Drawing is like her favorite thing, drawing and Minecraft. I usually don't let her play that much, but right now there's no school, so it's like, oh man, what? Bro, it's like even on the camera, look, it's like right there. I'll catch the finish on the upload. Right on, man. Cool. Do you sand the canvas? I find there is dust fuzzies from the factory dry time. No. Sanding them? I've never heard of anybody sanding the canvas. That is the first for me. And none of my artist friends, I've never ever heard that, sanding the canvas. No, I don't. Sometimes I wipe it off if I feel it's dusty, but... Like these, when you get them from the store, they come wrapped in a plastic. And yeah, they're like fully clean, wiped and everything. They look ready to spray. They're like individually wrapped. Yeah, I water down the juice sometimes. We buy the light juice. It's like light. We only give her apple juice too. And it's only the light. It's like already pre-watered down juice. At least when I tasted it, it tastes a lot less sweet. Fuzzies are stuck to the primer when you unwrap. I've never ever encountered that. That's strange. I've never ever encountered the fuzzies. And you sand them off, huh? Why can't you just like wipe them off? Because if you sand it, you're gonna have to wipe it anyway. I don't know. So before I load the black up, I'm going to load up some green. I'm going to rinse out this brown mixture here. Just gonna load up some fluorescent green to start. I'm not gonna throw any reducer in there. Just hot green straight out of the bottle. Get that, this piece. What else? A little bit of green on here. On this hand, yeah. I did that when I was 18. It's really hard to tattoo yourself. Alright, so then I'm going to take a little bit of forest green. I'm just going to add a couple drops into that. And now I'm going to add a couple or a little squirt of reducer. Ow. Then I'm going to shake it up. Schools are going back next year? What? That sounds wild. All right. different green here. I'm just building up all the tones on here. Okay. Then a little bit of turquoise into our mixture here. Justice having all kinds of fun with the with the emojis. What kind of air am I using, huh? Oh man, guys are funny, bro. Is the Neo a good start? Yeah, the Neo for Iwata is a decent airbrush. So long as you take care of it. Get something else. What's up, Bill? No Neo. Get something else. Get the Talon, the Eclipse CS. Yeah, honestly, guys are not wrong. How much does the Neo run for nowadays? I don't even know. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the Neo, but... Yeah, maybe for the money you can get yourself something a little better. Maybe. Because, yeah, the Talon would probably be a better buy if it's about the same price. Honestly. I don't know. It depends. What are you using it for, I guess? Okay, I think we got all that in there. Gotta give my hand a stretch. Oh, yeah. So, I'm gonna go ahead, take this green. I'm gonna set it aside. And we're gonna bring out the velocity. Oh yeah, bring out the velocity. You didn't miss anything, Bill. We just in here. Yeah, I don't know. It'd be worth comparing, man. I don't know how much a Neo goes for nowadays, but yeah. You might be able to find a better deal on something else. Something better, you know. So the Neo is kind of basic. And here's where the whole painting is going to start taking shape. And all that brown that you did almost seems to get muffled out. But it's honestly what makes most of the texture and what sets it apart. When you look at it close, then you realize you see all those little extra brown details in there. My video is not up yet. Probably go up tomorrow. And I said that yesterday, but I just haven't gotten around to editing it. I had moved all the files onto my computer, and then I just haven't gotten around to editing it. So editing takes a long time, and it's really boring. But I'll get on it, guys. I promise. It's already done. And, yeah. If you don't have a projector and you've been waiting for to get one, there's some pretty good information there you'll want to see before you buy one. The Skull Squad. Oh, yeah. Oh, dang, son. It's all nothing but skulls. That's dope. Yo, y'all gonna make me cry. Stop it. Stop it, y'all. Like, honestly, I can't believe how much we've come, how far we've come with the channel, like, in so little time. Well, I mean, if you subtract the whole 9 years before that, you know, this year's been amazing. There's not enough reducer on this. It's really thick. I need to spray just a little bit better. Skull to death. Bro, y'all are sick. Y'all are so sick. Yeah, I know. I said it yesterday. That's the last thing. Fuck. I totally forgot until now. And I was like, oh yeah, the video. It's like, ah. I just have to, like, open up the video editor and sit there. I have no excuse right now because there's nothing but time, but I have been cleaning the house and stuff. Oh, I just did that. Can I wipe it? Nope, it's gonna wipe the whole thing. Oh, look at that. I totally just did that. I flushed it back and then it fucking squirted everywhere. That's my biggest gripe with this plastic cap and the velocity. It's that, bro, I don't care that it's plastic. I don't know why it's sunken in. Like, you see how far this is in there? Like, it's like half, like not half the cup, but like a quarter of the cup is taken up. All I want to do is blow it back just so I can get that little fucking thing out of there, but it's fine. We'll fix it. It's fine. Story of my life. I should have turned the other way. I should have moved back. There's a lot of things I should have done. Yeah, and of course now it's spraying amazing because I got that little fucking piece out of there. So I probably won't be able to tell when we're done. I will be able to tell and that'll annoy me, but anybody who comes and checks it out won't be able to know. Won't know. It'll be our little secret. Seems that you can throw airbrush anything that's thrown at you. Yeah. Pretty much I try to make myself as flexible as I can. I hate airbrushing horses. See that up front? Horses are a weird animal to me. They just look weird. If I don't have a reference, like, that animal's gonna look a little fucked up. So, lesson number one, if you make a mistake, is always to not panic. Just keep working. And when you get to a proper spot, you'll fix it. Let's get the top of his head in there. Then we could go back and... Well, actually, we'll just finish this up, and then we can go back and finish that blue. We're gonna have to load up some white, fix that, but it's fine. Piece blends in right there, so that's one mistake all fixed up. This piece will probably be alright too. Let's come back and fix that blue on the edge, that'll be okay. If I make a mistake, are you busy? This trash. It sucks. It sucks after that. It's how you get your big headed away. You put your acting sometimes. You're left handed like me. What? Marik, hi. How's it going, bro? It's like the red caps in the paint bottle. What do you mean? Make it look like a unicorn. What? Are you guys having like a side conversation or some shit? I don't know. Or are you guys talking about Groot? Making Groot look like a unicorn. What did I miss? I feel like I missed something. Para saber, ¿verdad? Yo, guys, he wants to know how much. So he can tell his payees. Some white. Actually, yeah, I think we just need white in the eyes. Just so strange to me that people ask how much. I never, ever, ever, like in my whole airbrushing time, that never even crossed my mind, bro. Like, how much are other people charging? That never even occurred to me. Like, I just. I never cared what anybody else was doing. I still don't care what anybody else is doing. Somebody's out there charging thousands, like, more power to them, man. If people are paying it, you know, what can you do? People don't pay me thousands, right? So John Diekman, this year will be 20 years. I turned 34 this year. Just get rid of that little mistake right there. Mm-hmm, look at that, real nice. Real nice side. See, what mistakes? We didn't make no mistakes on here. This. You guys are imagining these mistakes, man. Okay, so a couple things need highlights. Now all we gotta do is come back with that little bit of blue that we had mixed up. Look at this. No mistakes. Go. I think that looks pretty darn good. Let's see. If we get you guys a shot without the glare. There you go. The only thing I really wish I would have done is made the brown a little more intense. But the lighting in this shot is kind of super intense. I'm trying to get it so you don't get that damn glare. I can't. There's no way to avoid that glare. Turn off that light. Then it just looks weird. And for some reason the back wall looks super bright now. Why? What the hell, man? I just want a good shot. I don't know. Hopefully once we get those new lights. Oh, look at that shot. Looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. I'm not moving it. Yes, they are features. They're not mistakes. These are happy additions to the painting here. Did I feel nervous when you asked? Yes, I was at a market. And I was set up with just a little round table and just like a little like canopy thing, like a not like a like a backyard style canopy, like a t like an umbrella, like a huge one of those super big umbrellas, you know? And I was just set up. I had like a little board and a shirt board, and I had one airbrush, and I had like a few colors. And people were walking up and be like, "Hey, can you airbrush my shirt?" And people were bringing me shirts because I didn't even have shirts, but I was set up like down the row from the lady that sold the shirts. So it all worked out in the end, and it was a lot of fun. But yeah, like once you get to talking to people and painting, and then the nervousness kind of just goes away. So at least for me, that's kind of how I got comfortable with it. And then it got to the point where there was crowds of people like watching. Yeah, sometimes it was more nervous about being like robbed, you know, than actually than nervous from anything else. So to be honest. But yeah, hopefully you guys like that video. Hopefully you guys like the Groot. He looks pretty good right there. So that'll go up on the wall over there. This is the wife's request. She's been wanting this. So I kept putting it in. I kept putting it in the polls. I didn't think it was gonna win today. Honestly, I thought you guys were gonna pick Spawn or, you know, the Goku, because people were talking about the Goku, but you guys didn't pick those. So here we are with a nice finished Groot. She gets her way nonetheless. Again, big shout out to Justice for the $5 donation during the chat, during the stream today. That helps offset the cost of the materials. And again, all you guys watching, whether you hit the like button, whether you subscribe, whether you become a member, or whether you just watch and you just lurk in the shadows, it all helps. It all helps. Even that one guy that likes to hit the dislike button, I got you, bro. I got you. It still helps anyway. Don't worry. So, thank you all guys for watching. What's up, Stephen Ward? Oh man, Stephen Ward shows up at the last second. John Diekman, Valentina Alvarado, Gustavo Vero. Who else showed up? Justice, Ertzad, the whole fucking Bill, Marik, Hater. The Skull Squad was owning the chat for a minute. So big shout outs to the Skull Squad. You guys rock. You guys are gonna keep these streams going, just you guys. So anyway, I'll get out of you guys' hair. I'll let you guys enjoy the rest of your day. I'm gonna go get a shower actually and try to enjoy the rest of my day. Take the baby outside for a second before it gets dark, and yeah, we'll see you guys in the next video. Laters.